the subject of machine design. So this is based on a question, previous grade question, from the topic of brakes. So I'm reading out the question. You can see the question on the screen. It's given that a mass of 2000 kg is currently being lowered at a velocity of 2 meters per second from the drum as shown in the figure. Mass moment of inertia of the drum is 150 kg meter square, and on applying the brake, mass is brought to rest in a distance of 0.5 meters and the energy absorbed with the brake is how much? The basic principle in any brake is the kinetic energy or any energy of the system is converted into heat energy. It is dissipated as heat. So whatever the heat is produced, it is absorbed with the brake or produced with the brake basically. So you just have to take the difference of energy before application of brake and after the application of brake. So that gives you energy absorbed with the brake. So as in this question, they're again asking you, that means in this question, they're asking you the energy absorbed with the brake. So simply let's get the difference of energy before application of brake and after the application of brake. Let's take the diagram. It is given that this particular pulley is there and a block is being lowered with some velocity. So this is 2 meters per second, velocity is, so this is V here, mass is given as 2000 kg and this is of radius 1 meter, it is given as 2 meters diameter, so it is radius of 1 meter, okay. So anyways, here, as nothing is given in the question that some loss are happening or this particular rope is slipping on this particular pulley, we can understand that pure rolling is happening or there is no slipping at all in this particular contact between the rope and the pulley. So based upon that, we can simply say V is equal to R omega, implies omega is equal to V by R, so 2 by 1, so 2 radians per second is the speed of rotation of the drum. Now as I said earlier, to get energy absorbed by the brake, we need to take difference of energy, initial energy, final energy, understand? Let's assume this particular block is from a height from the surface like this, height h. Now in the question it's given that this particular block is made to come to rest by making it to move to 0.5 meters. So it is given as 0.5 meters here. So it is coming to this location. So this is 0.5. Understand? Another thing given in the question is moment of inertia of the drum, that is given as 150 kg meter square. So moment of inertia of the drum is equal to 150 kg meter square. So energy absorbed is initial energy minus final energy. So let's get this particular change of energy here. So delta E, initial energy is nothing but potential energy of the block, kinetic energy of block, and moment of inertia of the drum is given, so we should take kinetic energy of the drum also. So this comes out to be mgh plus half mv square plus I omega square by 2. You know all the values except h. We don't worry about this. Let's look here. So it is initial energy, sorry. So final energy will become, we have, it is coming up to this height. So still the block is having some potential energy. But it is coming to rest. No kinetic energy. Eventually drum also will come to rest. So kinetic energy of the block and drum will become zero. So this gives you mg of, now the height is h minus 0.5. So to get delta E, you should take the difference. So if you simply take the difference, you will get the answer as half mv square plus I omega square by 2 plus mg into 0.5. You know all the values, if you substitute, you will be getting the final energy as 14.11 kilojoules. If you substitute all the values, you will be getting the answer as 14.11 kilojoules. So, that is the answer for this question. So, I hope the concept is very much clear. Simple energy conservation. I hope everybody is clear the solution. So, thanks so much, everyone.